You're watching The Wellness Hour, the leader in medical news and information. I'm Randy Alvarez. Today's topic, what you need to know if you're considering dental implants. My first guest is an expert on the topic, Dr. Bankhead. Dr. Bankhead, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Randy.
All right, now big topic, dental implants. I guess it's becoming very popular and I have a lot of questions. But first, tell me a little bit about your practice. I mean, you're a periodontist, obviously, but you know, what do you do? I mean, what are the procedures you do?
Well, a typical day in a periodontal office, you know, we're treating a lot of gum recession today. There's a lot of people who are uncomfortable with their receding gums. They don't like the appearance of it. They don't want to smile. They can't enjoy a cold beverage anymore. They can't hardly brush their teeth. So we're doing a lot of gum recession treatment.
So you fix that how?
We fix that by taking a piece of tissue and literally sewing it right into place. There's no scarring. There's no signs that we were even there. It is a perfect match every time.
Very nice. And a big part of your practice, I guess, dental implants. I mean, now most of the general dentists you work with, they send you the dental implant patients?
Correct.
So you do the surgical part?
Yes, we do the surgical part where we place the implant into the patient's jawbone, and then we typically send the patient back to the restorative dentist for them to do the teeth.
Okay. Gummy smiles are big.
Gummy smiles are huge. Do an awfully lot of those where a patient will come in, want to show more white rather than so much pink, and we'll reduce that pink away. They will get a new set of veneers or go get a set of veneers and they're done.
Okay, good. Now, let's talk a little bit about your background and training. I mean, you've been in and around dental implants for a long time, and by the way, you look very young. And I joked with you. I said, because you've placed about 15,000 dental implants.
That's correct.
And I said, it must have been right out of high school. But so let's talk a little bit about your background and training for a moment.
Yeah. Well, when I was in dental school, I was introduced to Gordon Christensen. And in the world of dentistry, Gordon Christensen is the man.
Okay.
And so, anyway, when I was about halfway through with my residency, he tapped into me and said, Alex, we want you to come to Provo, Utah and teach for us. And I thought at the time, great opportunity. So I spent years, or 10 years, being an instructor.
I mean, you were traveling all over the country, is that right?
All over the world.
Teaching doctors, other periodontists about what? Dental implants?
Dental implants and periodontal therapy.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Is that right?
So because of that, you know, you go give a lecture in Pittsburgh, 3 weeks later, I'd have a patient in my office from a general dentist who referred them from that lecture or that seminar.
Okay.
So because of that, we had a chance to treat a lot of people from all over the world.
Now your practice is one of the busiest, I've been told, in Utah, as far as dental implants. I mean, you do more implants than just about anybody out there.
Well, we're told we're the busiest from the implant company themselves. But, you know, Randy, we get to do these every day.
So is there a big learning curve with this? I mean, are you that much better now, you know, 15,000 cases later or implants later than you were? You know?
Absolutely. I mean, with dental implants, you know, every patient's different. Every situation's different. Yeah, there's a learning curve, and I'm definitely better today than I was at implant number 3.
And they're not painful, by the way.
Absolutely.
I mean,
not.
The patients don't complain about pain?
No, no.
It seems painful, by the way.
Well, bone tissue, Randy, has very, very few nerve endings.
Okay.
So there's not a lot of discomfort associated with them. Yeah, our gums have some nerve endings, but the bone itself has very, very little.
Interesting. Okay. Yeah. Now, teeth in a day is real. I mean, that's possible.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
So people could go in, get their implants in just a few visits, and they're ready to go.
Yeah, they with the technology that exists today, I mean, we have the ability to take a scan of the patient, treatment plan the case before they even show up for the implant placement itself. And so because of the technology, we're actually able to deliver the final product on some of these cases that same day.
But tell us that, or tell me this, why is it what used to take you guys with dental implants maybe 9 months or a year to do now can happen in a couple of visits?
Yeah.
I mean, what's changed?
Well, it's interesting you brought that question up, Randy, because when I was in my residency, it was a 9-month process. And I'll tell you, in the last 15 years, the implant companies become very smart. You know, they're doing the research. They're now providing us with surface characteristics of these implants that allow for a rapid bone growth to the implant, so the fusion of the dental implant to the patient is happening.
Okay.
In fact, I believe in very short order that they that the implant companies will provide us with an implant that has surface treatment to it, almost like dipped in something,
okay,
a growth factor of sorts. We're able to give you an implant today, and it's restored next week. I think that's going to be the routine rather than the exception to the rule as we're doing today.
So what are the different categories of dental implant patients that you see?
Well, Randy, we have those who are missing teeth in the back.
Okay.
Haven't paid much attention to them. We have those who are missing a front tooth, single tooth. We see a lot of patients, teenagers, who are missing their lateral incisors, and they're currently replacing them with a retainer that has some teeth on it.
Okay.
We've got those who have a failed bridge, missing a couple of teeth, decayed underneath the bridge.
Okay.
And then we got those denture patients. We got those who have had a denture for 40 years, think they're too old for this stuff. Then we got the denture patient who's had their dentures for 5 years, can't tolerate it.
And what are the age ranges of these denture wearers that you see that are candidates for dental implants?
Gosh, I'm treating a gal right now who's 30, complete denture at 30 years
really?
Old. And our oldest implant patient, 97, Randy.
Really?
97.
You know, I told you this, that you know, my mother, 75 years old, said, you know, my doctor told me I'm too old for dental implants, they'll fall out.
No, that's not true. That's an untrue statement. If you're living, breathing, you need teeth to eat well.
All right.
Okay. So if you are alive, you're the perfect age for dental implants. In fact, most of these patients, including my father, a retired dentist, said to me, I only wish I would have done this sooner.
Now, by the way, you know, I've had people say that the happiest, in all areas of dentistry, the happiest group of patients are those denture wearers that you could give them their teeth back with dental implants. Do you feel that's true?
Without a doubt, Randy. We're changing these people's lives. We're giving them their life back. We're allowing them to be socially comfortable again. They can go out to eat and not worry about their denture falling out. Or if they have a hot beverage, worried about their goop that's holding their denture in their mouth softening.
Is that right?
And literally melting and having the denture become unsecure. You know, we've got 70-year-olds today who are dating.
Yes, very young, 70, no doubt about it.
I have a patient who is 83 years old, recently just got remarried, and we're doing his dental implants. We're changing people's lives.
Now, if it's so good, you know, because according to you, two dental implants for denture wear, snap in, snap out, they can eat with. If it's so good, why isn't everybody doing it?
Randy, these patients don't know about it. They're not going to the dentist.
Okay, that's a good point. Okay.
I'm wearing a denture. I'm not going to the dentist.
So they don't know their options.
No, they don't know their options. You know, the denture patient is concerned about cost. They're concerned about the discomfort associated with it.
Because it does seem painful, no doubt about it.
Well, yeah.
But the bone doesn't, I mean, they have no feeling in the bone.
Correct.
Okay.
That's correct.
Let me back up for a second. We talked about the single tooth. But why a single tooth over traditional dentistry as far as dental implants? I mean, why are dental implants better than what dentistry has to offer?
Let me show you, Randy.
Okay.
Got a patient here who's missing a tooth.
Okay.
I've got a couple options. I can do a conventional dental bridge, or I can do a single tooth implant. To do the conventional dental bridge, the general dentist has to remove tooth structure, prep the teeth down, in order to deliver the bridge.
Okay.
Now, if this was your mouth, would you want this done?
Well, I mean, obviously I'd want a dental implant after talking to you, but this is the most popular procedure. Is that correct?
It's the most popular because it's been around the longest.
Okay.
And this is what general dentists do.
All right.
They prep teeth. So if the patient isn't given the option, this is what they're going to get.
Okay.
But most patients, I believe, if you gave them the option and said, in order to replace this missing tooth, we have to do this to the two neighbors, no one would do it.
All right.
But if you gave them this option, we can leave these alone, and I can give you something that doesn't decay, never breaks, never needs a root canal.
Just get a tooth back.
What would you do?
Right. But you say the general dentists are telling their patients about dental implants.
Absolutely. Absolutely. But I think a lot of patients aren't getting all the information they need.
Okay.
I think a lot of patients don't know what the dental implant costs.
Okay.
And assume that the bridge has got to be cheaper. In today's environment, a single dental implant is about the same as a bridge to replace that single tooth.
And does it prevent maybe future tooth loss, in your opinion?
Randy, as a periodontist, 20% of the surgical procedures I do on a daily basis is around a bridge. You're probably wondering why. Can you floss this?
No,
I guess not. No, I can't clean it very well. Another point, the insurance industry, life expectancy of an average dental bridge is 8 years. Life expectancy of a dental implant is the patient's life expectancy.
Okay, but back to the part where you were saying you're changing people's lives. How so?
Let me show you a case here, Randy.
Okay.
This guy here.
All right.
We're forcing him to smile for that shot. His teeth hurt, his gums bleeding, aching, teeth are decayed. He looks mad, he looks unapproachable. Let's look at him here.
Oh boy.
That's him.
So what's going on there, by the way?
This guy's got a whole bunch of problems. He's got dental decay, he's got periodontal disease, he's got root canals that are failing, teeth are abscessing, his mouth hurts. So we gotta get rid of some of his teeth.
Is that common, by the way, to see that?
Every day, see it all the time. You don't see it, but I see this every single
day.
Because
they don't smile, they're hiding
their smile.
They're
not smiling, you know. You might see this guy on the streets, or you may see him at the coffee shop, and he just looks like he's upset. Well, frankly, I see this every day, and their mouths are sore. Randy, for this guy, his options were extract his teeth and give him a denture, or extract his teeth and give him dental implants. So what we ended up doing, on the top, we placed 8 implants, fixed bridge work up top. On the lower, we did 4 implants, each restored individually. Let's look at his before and after.
All right, okay.
I mean, the guy's going to have to learn how to re-smile. He hasn't smiled
for
years.
That's a good point. Okay, he's forcing his smile there.
Absolutely. He hasn't smiled for 5 or 10 years. Smiling all the time.
It takes him about, what, 4 months to
learn how to smile? It's going to take him a few months to get used to his new smile. But this guy can now eat. He's eating properly rather than gulping his food and really eating a compromised diet. He's now able to eat healthy. He looks happy. He just got to learn how to smile again.
All right. So now, and this is non-removable. We talked about snap in, snap out, but
yeah.
This is a fixed set
of teeth. This is fixed, yeah. This doesn't come out.
And so how does he maintain these? He comes in every 6 months, every year?
He's now your regular dental patient. He's coming in every 6 months, seeing his general dentist and the hygienist. They're maintaining him. Live happily ever after.
Is that right?
Absolutely.
Is that right? Okay, so and that's a fixed set of teeth. Now, you brought a model and you showed me a little bit earlier. Now, for the 2 implants, though. Okay, so a denture, we're watching this, they have adhesive. Yeah. 2 dental implants could eliminate that.
2 dental implants will eliminate the dental adhesive. Snap in, snap out, able to eat whatever you want.
Okay, so this is it, and so there's, I'll try to show the camera this. So there's little underneath the denture, there's little facets,
yep,
or little holes, and then 2 implants,
yep,
just snap it in. Okay, and is that a popular one? I mean, is that something?
This is real popular. The nice thing about dental implants, Randy, you have somebody who has a denture sitting at home today, they can almost give this a trial run. Come in, we place 2 implants. We place, as you mentioned, they have the grommets on the underside of their denture snaps in. And most patients are completely happy with this. And for those who want a little bit more retention, we can offer them 4 implants that is retained with this bar clip. Now what this will allow the patient to do is enjoy sticky foods, a caramel. By having the back end anchored. Yeah. By having the back end anchored, the sticky food isn't going to pull the denture out.
All right.
So that's the advantage of the 4 versus the 2.
You know, and I said it, at the beginning that you change people's lives. I mean, so like a guy like this,
yeah,
do they ever come in and brag about what they're eating now?
They typically bring their friends in.
Is that right?
Because they have friends just like them.
So denture wearers are hanging out with each other.
Denture patients right. Hang out. So once we treat folks like this, we usually get 2 or 3 referrals from just that individual alone.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, does somebody need a referral to see a specialist like you?
Absolutely not.
So they could go directly to you, or they could talk to the general dentist.
They could talk to the general. Absolutely. The general dentist is a good place to get some information. But certainly, we see patients directly. You don't need a referral.
And now, it doesn't cost more to go to a specialist. Is that right?
I think it's cheaper to go to a specialist.
Is that right?
Yeah. And I say that because the more proficient we are at procedures, we can do them faster, easier.
You know, people are always asking me too. On wellnesshour.com, they email us and they want referrals. Who do you know in Utah? Who do you know here? And the fact of the matter is, we're not a referral site. I always say, I'm not endorsing the doctor. This is a real interview, by the way.
Yeah.
We haven't, nobody's reading teleprompters here. But I do tell them this. Look for a specialist. Go to a specialist. And number two, I always say, ask them how many of those procedures they've performed. Is that fair to say, by the way?
Absolutely.
And that goes with knee surgery.
Absolutely. As a specialist, we're probably more proficient. Because we're doing them day in, day out, it's going to take less time for the patient to have the treatment. They're going to get better care because we do it routinely. In my opinion, the specialist is the place to be.
And pain is not an issue, you
pain
say.
Pain is not an issue.
Are there those people that really, after total denture wears, now they get one of these teeth in a day procedures, that they're just taking ibuprofen or whatever you give them?
Absolutely.
I mean, are those people that don't even take medication?
There's patients who come in who report to us on their follow-up visit that they took no medication at all.
Really?
There's some who are taking ibuprofen, and there's very few that have to take anything beyond that.
Very interesting. So this is common. I mean, a case like this, a guy like this that's not smiling.
Every day, Randy.
Every day.
Let me show you another case.
Okay. This is a cowboy.
This is our cowboy, Mo.
Okay.
Take a look at Mo.
All right. He looks serious.
Mo is serious. Doesn't have any teeth.
Okay.
Mo comes into our office and wants teeth in an hour.
Okay.
Literally. He had heard about it on the television and wanted to explore it for himself. So Mo comes in. And with the technology that I was talking about, we're able to take a preoperative scan, farm his materials out to the laboratory, which then in turn provides us with a surgical guide. Mo leaves the office with four implants on the bottom, four implants on the top, dentures that snap into those, just like we showed.
Yeah.
And he leaves happy. Mo is able to leave today and go eat. On those implants.
It's a nice smile, by the way.
Beautiful smile.
You know, when you look at the guy in the before and the after, by the way, and did you ask him to smile on that before photo?
We were begging him to smile. That's as much as he would smile
really?
For us. Yeah.
Really? I was just kidding around. So that's his smile.
That's his smile.
And so this is him in the after. Very nice.
This is him leaving the office 2 hours later.
So he was walking around with just dentures that
dentures,
he didn't like.
Yes.
That he didn't like.
Mo had been a denture patient for 40 years.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Had him relined a few times, probably had him replaced a couple of times. But he was tired of always having to put something in his mouth to get him to stay put. He was tired of going to dinner and having to excuse himself to go rinse his mouth out because he's got particles underneath his denture. He was tired of not living. He was tired of not being able to socialize and do the things he wants to do.
I guess if you're dating, it's probably not a good thing to have dentures in your mouth.
It's not too cool.
So they feel like they're regular teeth or they don't think about it.
Yeah,
once they're in, I guess.
They're now living their life without worry of their teeth, Randy.
Okay.
They're able to, again, these people are out socializing. They're active people. They're out having dinner with their friends. They're doing activities.
Are denture wearers miserable, by the way? I mean, is there such thing as a happy denture wearer?
I don't know if there is. But I know that the implant patients who have their dentures secured and held by implants are very happy.
Do they say, I should have done this years ago? Do you hear that?
We hear that every single day.
You really do? I mean, they say that.
Oh, yeah. I have yet to meet a patient who says, I regret doing this. I wish I wouldn't have done it years. Wish I would have done it years ago.
Okay.
They all wish they would have done it sooner.
And what else are they surprised about? Is it usually the fact that they were worried about pain?
I think they're most surprised about the lack of discomfort. I think they're also surprised at relatively how inexpensive this stuff is.
Okay. Okay, good. Now you have more photos. We have time for a couple more photos. What else are we looking at over there?
Randy, let's look at this 78-year-old patient here. This gal has all sorts of problems. Her lower arch, she has dental decay, she has periodontal disease, her teeth ache, she has abscesses, she can't even chew. She's miserable. So what we did for her, we determined that her lower teeth needed to go. So we extracted them all. And once we did, her periodontal disease cleared up. The endodontic...
Periodontal disease is an infection.
Infection.
That makes the gums bad, right?
It's more than that, Randy. Okay. Periodontal disease is actual infection in the jawbone.
Interesting, okay.
And so once we get rid of these teeth that are so badly infected, the infection is gone.
And their gums get healthy?
Their gums close over, they become pink again, they're no longer red and inflamed. And in a case like this where we have this much infection in the jawbone, we allow for the gums to close over. That takes a few weeks. And then we come in and we place the dental implants. And infection-free bone, gums are healthy, everything's beautiful. And she leaves with teeth that are held permanently in place by her implants.
Okay.
Look at her smiling.
It's very nice. So no more dentures. I mean, is that the future of dentistry here then?
The future
when
is...
When I hear no more dentures?
The future is, if you choose, we can completely eliminate dentures. Or if you want to have something that is removable, we can provide implant-supported over dentures so that denture snaps in or snaps out, as we saw on the models here. Or if you want to step into a few more implants, we can eliminate dentures altogether.
Okay, then we're almost out of time. But for people just tuning in, we're talking about if you are missing one tooth, a few teeth, and especially if you have a loose-fitting denture, your options for this teeth in a day concept of putting dental implants for denture wearers, 2. Snap in, snap out.
Correct.
4 for something more stable, or maybe even 6 for something fixed in your mouth that never comes in and comes out. That's what it seems like everybody would want, though, right? I mean, nobody wants something that comes in and out.
That's exactly right. We can provide the patient with teeth that are just like yours and mine. They don't come in, they don't come out, but it does take 6 implants to do that.
Okay, now we mentioned also that if they're just tuning in, that you're, because you look very young, by the way, and I know your age, so you look about 10 years younger than your age. But you've done just about, I mean, there's not too many guys probably in all of Utah, in all of the United States, that have done as many as you have. I mean, about 15,000 implant cases.
That is correct.
Is that correct?
15,000 implants.
Implants.
Yes.
Okay. And you trained on the road.
Yeah.
Teaching dentists across the country for 10 years about dental implant dentistry.
That's correct.
Okay. So it's very nice. And you're a specialist periodontist. So where does somebody start? Somebody watching this, okay? Denture wear. They're still worried about all of this, or skeptical, or they think they're too old. What do you say to them? Where do they get their start? Come in for a consult, obviously?
Well, they can certainly do that. They can contact our office directly. They can pick up the phone and call their general dentist.
Okay.
Ask them some questions about implants. I would ask, do you do them? Do you do dental implants? Do you place dental implants? If the answer is no, call us directly.
So also your website. They could go to your website, learn a little bit more about dental implants, things
Absolutely.
Like that.
Absolutely. Our website has a lot of examples of before and after cases where the patient can find a situation probably identical to theirs and see the before and the after and really how their lives can be changed.
What about smokers? Because I was told smokers can't get dental implants.
Randy, I love smokers.
Really?
Absolutely. As a periodontist, we treat a lot of smokers. You know, smoking and periodontal disease go hand in hand. But certainly, a smoker can receive a dental implant just like you and I.
But don't they have to stop smoking?
Well, ideally,
during the healing process?
Ideally, we'd like them to.
Okay.
But the fact of the matter is, they're not going to stop smoking. We're going to encourage them to do it. And hopefully they will. Maybe this will be a light bulb moment for them where they finally have the motivation to give it up. But dental implants work even in our friends who smoke. Now, what we do ask of our smokers is, please allow us to see you a little more frequently.
Okay.
So that we can stay on top of things and prevent any problems.
And no smoking in the office. Right?
No smoking in the office.
No smoking in the office. So really, I mean, obviously, if you're in a cancer treatment or you have uncontrolled diabetes, probably not a candidate at that time. But just about everybody. I mean, you say 98-year-olds.
Yeah.
Have got. Now, why would a 98-year-old want to get dental implants?
Why wouldn't you want to? I mean, these are the people who are the most grateful, the most appreciative of what you've done, because you were literally giving their life back to them. They're able to go out and be comfortable. They don't have to go with their friends and worry about their denture falling out at dinner or falling out if they're laughing. These people are just thrilled. And their only regret is, I wish I would have done it earlier.
So teeth in a day happens, teeth in an hour.
Teeth in an hour. Teeth in an hour is happening today. It's going to become a bigger and bigger segment of the implant industry as we continue to use the technology that we have, the 3D imaging. The products are only going to continue to get better, and this is going to be the norm. People are going to walk into the office, and 2 hours later, they leave with a full set of teeth.
Good, good. So make your appointment.
So make your appointment.
Missing teeth, get in there, find out your options. How soon, by the way, will you know if they're candidates? So they come in that day, how soon do they get, you know, pricing information, all of that information?
Randy, within minutes, we know whether they're a candidate or not. I mean, literally, it's taken the x-ray, and the x-ray that we're taking is very, very accurate 3D image. So we see the patient as they really are. There's no more guessing. We're not having to extrapolate from a two-dimensional x-ray as we used to. We're seeing the patient in their entirety. We know where the vital structures are. We know where the nerves are. We know where everything is.
Okay.
They leave the office. They know exactly how long the process is going to take them, how much money it's going to cost them, and the anticipated timeline.
So at least know your options. And everybody, and it takes, I guess, a consult for that, right?
Yeah.
You got to come in for that.
You got to come in so we can see you. We need to gather the information, but literally within a half hour, you're in, you're out, you know what it's going to take to make that investment in you.
You do the consults, by the way?
Me
if
and my...
If they call, they may meet you?
Oh, absolutely. I meet with all my patients together with my treatment coordinator who's been with me for 13 years. We do all the new patient examinations. So, yes, we meet all the patients.
I want to thank you for coming to the show. Great stuff.
Absolutely.
Great
Thanks for having me.
You've been watching The Wellness Hour, the leader in medical news and information. I'm Randy Alvarez. If you would like to see this interview again, you could go on my website at wellnesshour.com. You can put in dental implants, no more dentures, teeth in a day, or Dr. Bankhead, of course. For now, I wish you good health.
Thanks for watching The Wellness Hour, the leader in medical news with your host, Randy Alvarez, the authority on health issues.